If you're gearing up to hit the beach this weekend, you're going to need to grab more than just your bathing suit. According to the American Academy of Dermatology, 1 in 5 Americans, perhaps you, will eventually develop skin cancer. So how do you protect yourself from the sun without skipping out on all the fun? Dr. Eric Bernstein is a dermatologist and laser surgeon, and he joins us this morning with ways on how you can protect yourself. Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Hey, let's talk about, you know, there's so many skincare products on the market, even some like here we have on our table. Which do you know is the right one to pick for you?
Well, you know the problem is there's so many, and you're advertised to by so many people. You really need to ask a professional. I pick a few brands that I know are good.
What about the SPF factor? What's that determines the amount of protection, right?
Yes, but it's complicated. For when you're outside, the most important thing, if you're swimming and enjoying the sun, water skiing, you need a sunscreen that's going to stay where you put it. So you need waterproof. I like Copper Tone Sport in a blue bottle, 48, because I need it. I'm light. And for kids, I use the Copper Tone Sport for kids.
Tell us about there's so many suntan lotions on the market now, they're going higher. Used to be 15, maybe 25, 30 was the maximum. Now they have it going up to 60. Does that provide us the best protection? Do we need to have something, wear something on our bodies that is up in the SPF 60?
Well, it's extremely complicated. We do, but the problem is the more ingredients you get, the more chance you have of having a reaction to the sunscreen. And a lot of times to get the high SPFs, you have to put more chemicals in. And the second thing is sunscreens break down in the sun. So you need formulas that are going to be stable. And how are you going to know that? You're not. You need to ask your dermatologist. They'll have some favorites that they'll recommend to you. But the higher SPFs are necessary. Because in addition to sunburn and skin cancer, skin aging, you know, and that happens all the time, even while we're in a car.
But tell me, what's the difference between going with, say, an SPF 30 versus an SPF 60?
Well, the real difference is you can spend more time in the sun without getting burnt. I think the key, though, if you're active outside, is to get, I'd rather have a waterproof 30 than a not waterproof 60 if I'm going to be active. For daily wear, I use a 60. Mm-hmm. In fact, I buy one that's not available in the U.S. I go on the internet. It's not FDA approved yet.
That's a little risky. So what would you recommend as we show our viewers now some of the best ways to protect your skin? You say use a sport sweat-proof sun lotion.
Yes. Sweat-proof sun lotion, Copper Tone Sport, blue bottle 48 is what I use for myself. For my kids, I use a green aquamarine bottle, Copper Tone Sport for kids.
Use the sunscreen daily?
Absolutely. I use one daily, and I put it on my kids daily in the spring and summer.
And when you're going outside to do some gardening or even hanging out at the beach, you want to get the large hat that just sort of covers the best part of your face and maybe the back
Absolutely.
Of your neck?
Absolutely. A hat helps, but a hat gives you SPF maybe 5 or 4. It's less than you would think because light reflects up, and the light that damages us is completely invisible. I have a laboratory where we study these things. You cannot appreciate what invisible light is till you get completely burnt.
And tell us about at what point do we need to check and start to visit a dermatologist like yourself regularly?
You know, I think everyone needs to go regularly. And for me, there's really no downside.
At what age do you think?
I took my kids soon after they were born. They just got looked at, looked for birthmarks, and there's certain things you look for when children are born. And I take my family and go myself once a year.
When we were talking about young kids, is there a difference in the type of sunscreen that we should put on the children rather than the adults?
Well, yeah, for me there is. And you really have to ask the pediatrician. Some pediatricians will say no sunscreen under 6 months, but there's chemical-free sunscreens. Clarins makes a good one that you can put on children that have no chemicals in them.
So. And how often do you put it on? Every time you go? I mean, because I usually think that if you go in the water, you should put some on, even if they say it's waterproof?
Oh, there's no question about it. You know, when you walk in the sun, sunscreen starts sweating off, even if they're sweatproof, and they start breaking down.
So if you go in the water, make sure
if you go in the water 100%, you put it on when you come out. But even if you don't go in the water, I mean, believe me, I know. There's type 1 through 6 skin. I'm like a 0. Mm-hmm. So if I don't reapply it every hour, I'll feel it. So I reapply like every hour. Your average person every couple hours, certainly when you come out of the water. The other thing people don't know is that most of the sun that I get, and probably you too, because I know you're busy, is in the car.
Right.
And people don't even think about that. But we
Because the rays are coming in through.
Yes,
through
they are. The burning UVB rays don't, but the UVA rays come right in.
We want to thank you so much for joining us. Some great advice, Dr. Eric Bernstein. Thanks for being here this morning. More information on what Dr. Bernstein is offering his advice, just log on to our website.